did that? That's me on a bull. They are funny. That bull is alive, and I can tell you I am an adventurous person. But once I sat down on that bull, I definitely regretted it because he took a little bit of a step. And so my hand is up because I'm praying and saying, in the name of Jesus, please keep me safe. That's why my hand is up. So yes, my name is Sister Josephine. Last night when I was watching the feed go by on the Twitter and the Instagram, somebody said, I'm so excited and I just can't hide it. Is that person here? We're on the same wavelength. I was like, that person understands me. Like they're with me. There you are. Thank you. I am so excited. I just can't hide it. I love that. I'm so grateful to be here with you this morning. I am a sister of the Holy Family of Nazareth, and we have a table out there. It had some free stuff on it, but all of you took it last night. Okay, raise your hand if your hands are really sanitized and your lips are super glossy. We know who you are. Okay. We hope you enjoyed the free gifts, and we're going to restock them. But please come by the table because the sisters are here. Myself, Sister Manuela, and Sister Mary Paul, who I know everybody knows. So we would love to talk with you and meet you. So just really briefly about me, I'm a native Texan. I actually grew up Baptist, so can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. I actually converted to Catholicism 12 years ago, so I became Catholic 12 years ago, and I entered college. Amen. Great decision. Even greater decision was when I entered the convent 5 years ago, and a year and 6 months ago yesterday, it was 1 year and 6 months ago yesterday, I made my vows and said yes to being a spouse of Jesus Christ. Yeah. And so, I think because I'm a convert, like I still get really amazed by everything that's going on in the church. Like I walked in this room and I was like, that screen is huge. I love being Catholic, you know? I walk in here and I'm like, this band is awesome. I love being Catholic. Like everything still just really amazes me. And I'm still very like observant. So I don't know if you've noticed, but these conferences, they always have a theme that's a verb. And so it's like seek, thirst, arise, behold. Like, it's so active, right? You guys are probably so tired when you go home. Like, what have you been doing all weekend? I've been holding, man. Like, I'm exhausted. What did you do last year? I was rising. And then who was at Steubenville? Y'all thirsted, okay? Y'all were thirsting all weekend, okay? So they're so interactive. And it always is, I don't know, it's just interesting to me. Next year, it's going to be like, run. All right, and then you'll really be tired. And so I think I'm going to talk about the Blessed Virgin's yes this morning. And so when I first received the invitation to share with you, it just kind of made me think about yes in my own life. And part of it can be really, really delightful. And a lot of times when people get up to speak, they'll show you pictures of their family. So I'm going to introduce you to my family. There they are. That's my family. Great ladies to live with. We're in Grand Prairie, so you can actually come and meet them in person. That's my family, and since I said yes to sharing life with these sisters through the vows, there's a lot of like wonderful, delightful surprises, and one story I'll share is about Sister Geraldine. She's the one on the far right who's got that beautiful smile. She's right behind me in the wheelchair in the white sweater, and I have an even better picture of her that kind of gets more close up on how beautiful she is. Sister Geraldine. So early on when I moved into the convent, Sister Geraldine at that time was not in a wheelchair, she used a walker. And so one day I was coming down the hallway and she was rolling down the hallway on her walker and she didn't look like she felt very well. So I stopped Sister and I said, Sister, how are you? You feeling okay? You doing okay? And she said, you know what? I think I've got a fever. I've got the shakes a little bit. And so I said, oh, I'll go get Sister Monica. Sister Monica's the nurse. I said, let me go get Sister Monica. She can help you. And Sister Geraldine said, no, don't go get Sister Monica. I will take care of it. I said, yes, Sister. And then I went and got Sister Monica. and told her that Sister wasn't feeling well. And so I didn't see Sister Geraldine anymore that night. And the next morning, we were passing each other again in the hallway. And this is just one of the delightful surprises to me. We're passing each other in the hallway, and I'm on one side, she's on the other, and she kind of cuts her walker. in front of me. And I'm like, oh, maybe sister doesn't see me. So I step to the other side, and she cuts back. And I'm like, okay, she definitely sees me. And all of a sudden, I feel like I'm in an episode of Nuns in the Hood, okay? Like, cause this woman is like, she's rolling up on me at this point, okay? And she rolls up on me, and she says four words. She says, I know you snitched, okay? And I'm like, my jaw is on the floor, and then she cuts her locker to the right, and she rolls off, like, gangster style, like, rolls off. And I, my jaw is on the floor, and all I can think is, I love the convent, okay? It is so delightfully surprising when we say yes, like, all these wonderful things we experience when we say yes. So what I'm going to do is share a little bit of the fruit of my own life of prayer with the Blessed Virgin Mary. I'm not a theologian, so when they invited me, what I can give you is what God has given to me in prayer and the fruit of some of my relationships. The last time that I reflected on the Gospel of Luke, really deeply reflected on it, was on my retreat that I was on last summer. I was on a 6-day silent retreat, which is wonderful. It can sound overwhelming, but it's wonderful. I was on a 6-day silent retreat, and it was at a Jesuit retreat house. And the priest invited me to imagine that I was, if we can have the next picture, please, to imagine that I was at the Annunciation. So, like, to imagine that I was in the room. And if you ever pray with a Jesuit priest, their style of prayer can be very imaginative. And that's helpful to me, because I like to imagine what I would say, or imagine what other people would say, or what people would look like in the scene, and how they would interact. And so this priest invited me to enter into this scene, the scene of the Blessed Virgin Mary receiving this invitation. And then he said, and then talk with her. What would your conversation be with her? And so I went into the scene, and I meditated on this gospel. Luke, chapter 1, verse 26. And forward. In the 6th month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. And Mary said to the angel, How shall this be, since I have no husband? And the angel said to her, The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your kinswoman Elizabeth in her old age has conceived a son. And this is the 6th month with her, who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible. And Mary said, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word. Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word. And the angel departed from her. And so in obedience to the instructions of this priest, as the angel departed from her, I imagined what would I say to the Blessed Virgin. And sometimes, y'all, I can be really real in my prayer, and I can be sassy. And I imagine that as soon as the angel departed, I would put my hand on my hip and said, Mary, do you know what you just said yes to? It's actually what I imagined in my prayer. And so I thought, okay, let me go with this. I believe that's what I would maybe say to Mary. What would she say back? Realistically, and what I imagined in my prayer was that she would say no. She doesn't know what she said yes to, and we heard that at the beginning of the Stations of the Cross. She knows it might be hard, but she really doesn't know what's going to happen in the next hour, in the next day, in the next month. She really doesn't know. And so I imagine that she would have said no. And then I imagine that I would have said, then why did you say yes, right? Because we all want to know how it's going to end before we make the agreement. I get to talk with women about their vocational discernment, and so many times I'll hear that. I just want to keep visiting until I know that it's all going to be okay, and then I can enter. You know, I want to date this guy for, you know, 20 years so I can be guaranteed that it's going to be okay, and then I can say yes. All right? And so I'm thinking, why did you say yes? And I'm sitting there in prayer, and the next words that floated into my mind were, "Because I love God." And I think that's a legitimate, possible answer for the Blessed Virgin Mary, for her to say, "Because I love God." And then what I imagined myself saying back to her next, it got kind of serious then. I said, "Mary, why do you love him? Why do you love him? Why do you believe? Why would you say yes even though you know it's not going to happen? You don't know what's going to happen in the next hour. Why would you say yes? Why do you love him that much?" And as I was sitting there in prayer, the words that came to my heart and my mind were these: "Because he made me." God could have made anything in his infinite love and his infinite wisdom and his infinite perfection. He could have made anything. He could have made anyone. And he made me. So let's go back to Mary's words. She says, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord." And so I'm a big time Googler. And so if I'm going to be beholding all weekend, I Google, well, what is behold, okay? If I'm going to do it all weekend, what does it really mean? And so when I looked at, like, what does this word behold really mean? That the Virgin Mary, she didn't say yes. And I sometimes wonder what she would feel about that. Like us describing probably the greatest word she ever spoke in her life as like a yeah, you know? She says, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord." When I looked up what behold means, before it was like to look or to see, it meant to thoroughly hold. To hold thoroughly to something. So Mary says, "I'm gonna hold thoroughly to who I am." That's her yes. I'm gonna hold on thoroughly to who God says I am. And so, because I'm gonna do that, let it be done to me according to your word. Let it be done to me according to your word. I'm going to hold. So we're going to be like Mary. We're going to hold thoroughly to who God says we are, his sons and his daughters. And so that holding thoroughly, I believe, this is me, I told you I'm not a theologian. I believe that when Mary said, "I'm going to hold on thoroughly to who God says I am," who does he say? What does he say about what he makes? In Genesis, it's Genesis chapter 1. Verse 31, "And God saw everything that he made, and behold, it was very good." So Mary is holding thoroughly to what God said way back in Genesis, to hold thoroughly to the fact that what he makes is very good. His sons and daughters are very good. This is our yes. And so as much as I was so delightful, you know, it's so delightful, the experiences I get to have with the sisters, our yes is not a guarantee that once we say yes, everything's going to go great, and it's going to be this really smooth road. And it's also not, it's not always going to be the cross. It's going to be all those things and everything in between. Our yes is about no matter what circumstance we find ourselves, we hold thoroughly to who God says we are. In whatever circumstance we find ourselves, whatever challenge we find ourselves, we can profess that and say, "Behold, I'm going to hold thoroughly that I am the servant of God. I'm going to hold thoroughly that I am the son or daughter." When we do that, when we can say yes to who we are, then I believe we are folded up into the family of God. We're folded up into the family of God, and we get the fruits, we get the promises of the covenant. And what the covenant says is that I will always be with you. God will always be your father. Jesus will always be your savior, and Mary will always be your mother. So when we hold thoroughly to who we are caught up into the family of God. And so whether we're in really delightful circumstances or if we're in really difficult circumstances, we will always be a part of that family. We'll never be alone. So this is what our yes gives us. When we hear those words, "Behold your mother," that's the focus of this morning's segment for you all. Behold your mother. When we hear those words, we hear them in John chapter 19, 27. And where is Mary? When we are instructed in scripture to behold our mother, Mary is not being assumed body and soul into heaven at that time. She's not being crowned queen of heaven and earth when we are instructed to behold our mother. When we're instructed to behold our mother, she's at the foot of her son's cross and her heart is pierced. And so we're told to behold a woman who, if she can stand at the foot of the cross as her perfect and innocent son dies, she can most certainly stand at the foot of any crosses in our life and also participate in as our mother in the joys that we experience as well and everything in between. Amen. Behold your mother. The last picture I would like to share with you. So as I said, that's my best friend. She just had her first baby. And I don't know. I wanted to see if we could. I am going to ask you to pray for her. But first, I just want to tell you. So I said that when we give our yes, when we say, I'm going to hold firmly to who God says I am, then we step into this covenanted ground with God. We're in the family of God, and it means that we don't walk alone. And so my best friend, she just said yes. Her baby is 3 months old. His name is Julian. And she'll be really happy that I picked a cute picture of her. She would have killed me if I didn't pick a cute picture of her. And like I said, we've been best friends for 20 years. And so there's a lot of joys that she's experiencing as a new mother, but there is also a lot of struggle that she experiences as a new mother. And so she needs our prayer. She needs our prayer. And Emmanuel, I don't know if you were able to reach her on FaceTime, but if not, we'll send her a video of this later. But I want to ask if we can make, kind of hold true to what I'm saying, that when we give our yes, that we don't go it alone, that we are together in the family of God, and that Mary is our mother, she's the mother of all mothers, that God is our Father, Jesus is our Savior. So I just want to ask if we could entrust my best friend as she kind of grows into her motherhood, if we can entrust her into the hands of the mother of all mothers. And I want to ask us to all join together and pray a Hail Mary for her. All right? Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Thank you. I don't know if I went over time, but because the clock wasn't on here, but they told me before I got on stage, if you go over time, a trap door will open and you will drop to the pits. So I'm still here.